All right, so what you're looking at here is your like a progress report. So when you go back to in-center, or just when you when you're doing dialysis, dialysis units will give you progress reports to let you know how good you're doing. Right, so it's not just this like nebulous thing that, you know, nobody knows what's going on, but what it has here is all the things that they test for, like potassium, like phosphorus is on here. And there it is, phosphorus, hemoglobin, and these gray parts here, as you can see, are the parts that the ranges that they measure it. So if like one of these lines here goes above this chart on the side, that means you're either above or below, excuse me, you're either too much or you're too little. But as you can see, and this was a couple of days ago, they did this. Mine are pretty within range, which is a theme for me. It kind of looks like this. So whether you are on home or you're in the center, these progress reports come every time you do your blood work, every time they do the blood work. And they do the blood work monthly to make sure that you're hitting your targets, and they make sure that like complications don't happen as a result of like a diet. They also measure with this the efficiency of your dialysis treatments to make sure that you're getting adequate enough dialysis, cleaning your blood, and so on and so forth. So what this chart does is it gives you a guideline of the things that you need to know, which can help you significantly in your own care. So if you know that you have a phosphorus problem, you know, you can kind of try to see if you can track that back to if you're eating a lot of high potassium foods, or if you're eating a lot of phosphorus foods like nuts, for example. And you can increase or decrease accordingly. So this is a guideline for that, and it can help you. It's also another way for you to feel proactive, right? Because a lot of this, a lot of dialysis, a lot of all of this is going to feel like these are just things that are just out of your control, right? But this is something that if you are cognitive, you try to pay attention, these are things, this chart here, you know, these are things that you can help prevent or do something about. And the better these labs look, the more favorable it looks towards transplant, because it tells them that you can follow instructions. It tells them that you have discipline. It shows them that, you know, if you get a kidney, you're not just going to just go right back to doing the same habits that you did before.